Hello everyone, I am Shalini Singh, Assistant Professor in Department of Commerce at GIMS Engineering Management Technical Campus. In today's lecture, we are going to discuss about the scope of total income, Indian income and foreign income. So in this lecture of income tax law and practices, we are going to discuss about the scope and the residential status. As in the last class, we discussed about the incomes which are exempted under section 10 of Income Tax Act 1961. So, in the last lecture, we discussed about this. In today's lecture, we will discuss about the scope of income tax, scope of total income under section 5. So, section 5 of Income Tax Act 1961 provides the scope of total income in case of a person who is resident in case of a person or in case of a person not ordinarily resident in India. And a person who is not resident, which includes income can be from any source, which can be which is received or is deemed to be received in India in such year or by or on the behalf of such person, or it accrues or arises or is deemed to accrue or arise to him in India during such year, and accrues or arises to him outside India during such period. So, basically if we talk about the scope of total income, basically the scope of income depends upon the residential status of an individual. So, now let us see what is the residential status of an individual in case of income tax. It is important for income tax department to determine the residential status of a tax paying individual or a company, and it becomes particularly relevant during the tax filing session. In fact, this is one of the factors based on which a person's taxability is decided. So, taxability of individual in India depends upon his residential status and for that particular financial year. Also, we should note that the residential status of different types of persons, for example, an individual, a firm or a company, etc., is determined differently. So, in this article, in this lecture, we will discuss about how the residential status of an individual taxpayer can be determined for any particular financial year. So, how to determine the residential status? So, for the purpose of income tax in India, the income tax law in India classifies the taxable person as number 1 a resident, number 2 a resident not ordinarily resident, number 3 a non-resident. So, the taxability differs for each of the above three categories of the taxpayers. So, before we get into the taxability, let us first of all discuss and understand what a taxpayer, when a taxpayer is a resident, a resident not ordinarily resident or a non-resident. So, let us discuss what is a resident. A taxpayer would qualify as a resident of India if he satisfies any one of the following two conditions. So, the following two conditions: number 1, stay in India for a year, that is, or it is 182 days or more, or stay in India for immediately 4 preceding years, is that is 365 days or more and 60 days or more in the relevant financial year. So, in the event if an individual who is a citizen of India leaves India for employment during any financial year, he will qualify as a resident of India only if he stays in India for at least 182 days or more than 182 days. Such individuals are allowed to longer time or greater than 60 days and less than 182 days to are allowed to stay in India. So, however, the financial year for the financial year 2021, the period is reduced to 120 days or more for such an individual whose total income exceeds, other than foreign source, exceeds rupees 15 lakh. So, in another significant amendment of financial year to 2021, an individual who is citizen of India who is not liable to tax in any other country will be deemed to be a resident in India. So the condition for deemed residential status applies only if the total income other than foreign sources exceeds rupees 15 lakh or nil, tax liability in other countries or territories by reason of his domicile or residence or any other criteria of similar nature. Secondly, of a resident, not ordinarily resident, if an individual qualifies as a resident, the next step is to determine if he or she is a resident, ordinarily resident, or resident, not ordinarily resident. So he will be a resident, ordinarily resident, if he meets both of the following conditions. If he has been a resident of India at least 2 out of 10 years immediately a previous year and has stayed in India for at least 730 days in 7 immediately preceding years. Therefore, if any individual fails to satisfy even one of the above condition, he would be treated as resident, not ordinarily resident. So from the financial year 2021, a citizen of India or a person of Indian origin who leaves India for employment outside India during the year will be a resident and ordinarily resident if he stays in India for an aggregate period of 182 days or more. However, this condition will apply only if his total income other than foreign source exceeds rupees 15 lakh. Also, a citizen of India who is deemed to be a resident in India will be a resident and ordinarily resident in India if the income, and it should be noted that income from foreign source means income which accrues or arises out of India, except income derived from the business controlled in India or profession set up in India. So this is the resident, not ordinarily resident. Next one is non-resident. A non-resident is an individual who satisfies none of the above conditions of either resident or resident, not ordinarily resident. Then that person will be considered as a non-resident for the year. Now let's see the taxability of these individuals residential status. If he is a resident, the resident will be charged to tax in India on his global income, that is income earned in India as well as the income. So let's see the taxability of these residential status of individuals. So a resident will be charged to tax in India on his global income, that is income earned in India as well as income earned outside the India. So in case of non-resident and resident, not ordinarily resident, their tax liability in India is restricted to the income they earn in India. If they are earning in India, then they are taxable to that income, but the earnings which they are bringing from the foreign, that is not taxable. So they need not to pay any tax in India on their foreign income. This is the table of scope, where we can see the residential status of the individuals who have to pay the taxes. So number one, income received in India is taxed in all the three cases, if he is resident, if he is not resident, if he is resident, not ordinarily resident. So in all the three cases, in all the three residential status, he will be taxable. Income deemed to be received in India, in that case also it will be taxable in all the three cases. Income accrues or arises in India, that all the three are also taxable in all the three cases. Income deemed to accrue or arise in India, that is also taxable in all the three cases because all the incomes are earned in India. Income accrues or arises out of India, it is taxable only in case of resident because the resident is earning in income in India as well as he is earning it from the foreign country. So that is taxable. And number six, income accrues or arises outside India from business or profession controlled or set up in India. In this case, two residential status will be taxed, that is resident and resident, not ordinarily resident. In both the cases, there will be the taxability. And in the seventh case, income other than above, that is no relation in India, then only resident is taxed in this case. So this was the scope of in total income which we are earning in India as well as outside the country. So we can see that it depends upon the residential status of an individual whether he will be taxable in India or not. So deemed income is not actually accrued, but it is supposed to be accrued notionally. Income accruing or arising outside shall not be deemed to be received in India within the meaning of this income tax section. So these are the few scopes which we can see. That's all for now. Thank you.